Is that a wrap? Are we good? Is that a wrap, man? Come on, man. Stop playing, man. Come on, let's go.
Test. Welcome to WFM Radio. This is In Between Pieces, brought to you by Writings from Michael, where I discuss entrepreneurship from the lens of an artist and business mindset. This conversation is made with love and joy for your mission, your purpose, your calling, and your journey. Welcome with love. Peace. Are we on? Are we back with this episode? Come on, man. Let's stop playing. We're back with WFM Radio In Between Pieces. I'm your host, Michael G. Simpson from Writings from Michael. Now, it's been a blessing just to be able to speak in front of you guys. Like I said, shout out to my man, Junior, making the actual camera crispy. And today's episode, I wanted to dive right into it. It's about being imperfectly perfect. Now, perfectionism is something that I feel like a lot of us chase, a lot of us have dealt with, right? Whether you're young, older, especially dealing in the heights of social media presence, being so prevalent in front of us, man. I mean, each and every day we're invited to a new picture video where it seems perfect when it's far from the case. Shout out to this wonderful, I guess, supporter. Let me just see the page real quick. Paige Thomas. Shout out to Paige Thomas. Her underscore is I am Paige Elise. And now she posted a comment under a video I just recently posted, which I'm recording this today, you guys see. It's the, what, today, Junior? 16th of August. And she said, I needed this advice today, dude. I've been struggling making the perfect camera setup to capture my art and forgetting about what actually makes me as an artist. I mean this in the most non-creepy way possible. You're amazing. I love you. Thank you for the advice and inspo. Much love, Paige. Now, I want to dive right into this actual topic because perfectionism does kill creativity sometimes. And I remember first starting, and I say about 2015, 2016. I moved to California in 2015, 2016. I really got my feet wet what I'm doing now art-wise and had this inclination of wanting to chase perfectionism, right? I didn't have the right camera. I didn't have the right utensils. I didn't have the right things in place. But instead of trying to look for the right things, usually the opportunity of the right things is right in front of you, right? Last episode, we talked about having your phone, right? Leveraging your phone, the social media. This is about perfectionism, right? Now, to touch on what her question is there really a perfect camera setup? And I think it's a learning point, right? Because even with this podcast, right? For an example, use WFM as an example. Junior would tell you, I started this podcast, right, with one first an idea. So the fact that you even have the idea to want the perfect camera setup is fucking amazing because it shows that you want more. It shows that you want to create more. And as us artists, innovators, entrepreneurs, it is our job and duty to push the world forward best way we can. So give yourself a round of applause for that, right? Now, back to using as examples, like, I started this with a phone, right? Got a tripod off of Amazon for $20, $22 with shipping, and just started recording. And as I was getting feedback from Junior, yes, he may not think it's the greatest quality, but the point is to get it out first, right? Get the content out, get the pieces out. And it goes to any industry you're in, right? Whether you're doing podcasts for a living, whether you're doing real estate for a living, whether you're doing training for a living, whether you're doing arts for a living, doesn't really matter. I mean, sometimes we have to forget the quality, even modeling, right? Sometimes forget the quality and just go on a volume spectrum, post it, because the fear is crippling us to think that we need perfectionism when really we need just the drive to keep on going. I came across this quote on TikTok. Shout out to TikTok. I keep on mentioning TikTok. I need to figure out a deal here. I came across this quote. It was like motivation difference to consistency. And I kind of thought about it and made me think for the day was like, I no longer am in a space where I need to be motivated to do anything. I need to stay consistent. I need to stay disciplined. I need to stay rooted into the process. Now, if you take that same mindset where staying disciplined, staying rooted into the process, that perfectionism doesn't need to exist because the consistency of you putting out or doing on a daily basis, you are going to improve on a daily basis. And that's what it's about. Improvement and progression. Like, fuck the perfectionism shit. Like, I know we're, like, seeing it on a daily basis, but... And it's difficult to say that, right? Like, you don't need to be perfect, right? Imperfectly perfect, right? Be imperfectly perfect. And let's try to find a balance of, like, just putting out. And then over the course of time, you can look back and say, damn, shit has improved. Things have improved. Things are getting better. And things will continue to get better. It's just crazy how society has shifted into this perfection glam. And coming up as a kid, I can only imagine having these constraints or these like expectations to put out perfect work. I always say about like, I am truly an example of not putting out perfect content. Like even when I don't have the things in place, it's like, okay, how can we be creative to put this out? Even though it might not be the greatest quality, the thought is still there, right? The execution is still there. The preparation is still there. All these things are in place just besides the quality. And at a certain point, we'll attract the right people to come on our empires that we're building and movements that we're building to patch it up and put quality. Like I said, shout out to my man Junior for just believing in what I'm doing and adding that quality. People will come to what you're doing. You got to show that work first. No one's just going to just give you this quality and create this beautiful mirage of things, man. You got to show that workout first, and you start to just slowly build. So I say, keep on building. You know, before 1 second here, I just want to read off a poem that I was, writing about. Hold on 1 second, guys. Here we go. A life worth living. Even if the outside is blind to your dream, you still grasp further in between. A life led by love. Don't let the outside world mold you into fear. A life led by love, I feel a blessing is near. So I write this poem because, one, I love poetry. I'm a poet, a designer, a painter. But this is really just to say, a life led by love, if you're doing what you love to do, right, whether you are doing that in full totality or not, if you are waking up with true gratitude, right, just grateful for people around you, right? For me, it's my wife. Could be wife and kids. Could be your boyfriend, your girlfriend, whoever it brings you joy, your friends, your family. These are the true blessings. Let's not get sidetracked to what the perfect life is. This is, right? The gratitude. These are the things that can't be measured, can't be priced. It is priceless. So I leave it off with you, man. A life led by love, right? Imperfectly perfect. Fuck the perfect life. Right? The perfect life is the life you're building with love. That's a life led by love. That's a life worth living. I'm going to sign off right here. This is WFM Radio In Between Pieces. Let's continue to live a life led by love. Stay limitless. Much love. Peace. And you just listened to WFM Radio In Between Pieces. Please like, subscribe, download, and spread this conversation with love and joy. Keep going on your mission, your purpose, your calling, and your journey. Much love. Peace.